Hello learners, welcome to this session on staging events. In this session, you will learn about the event design, you will learn about the theme, how to create theme about an event, how to do the stage in different kind of prospects. Like staging have different kind of different kind of elements which need to be taken care. So that we will go through in this session. But first of all, I'll just briefly tell about myself, my intro. I'm Manish Agarwal. I'm industry expert in event management, and I'm into event design and planning, and I'm associated with many big events like India Art Fair, Comic Con, India Fashion Week, India Design, and lots of high-end weddings also, and lots of corporate events, lots of NGO events, lots of social events. So this is what I've done, and I'm into it, and I'm also course leader in Pearl Academy School of Contemporary Media, New Delhi, and I'm taking event management as a subject. So we'll just go through the lesson as per our subject. So I'm sharing the screen. So we'll just go through. So this is like staging events, staging introduction and elements. So we'll just go through these elements. What are these? What are the main aspects? What are the main prospects we should know? So these are very important things we need to know. And these are like staging. What is a staging? Staging is a theatrical concept originating from the presentation of plays at the theater. What it means? Very simple thing if you say. It's like the theaters, when theater used to happen, theater started from nicks and corners of the streets. Theater started in many, many cities in bygone eras. But you know, when theater came to the proper place, proper auditoriums being made up, proper setups being made up. So the requirement for the staging came up. And when the requirement for the staging came up, what it means? It means we need to create them aesthetically. We need to create them in a creative manner, which is very, very important. And so the need for theme design came into existence. Yes, we really need the kind of theme for any kind of production, any kind of event, any kind of stage theatrical, which is really important. And in event staging, all the elements of event production are brought together in coordination for presentation before the audience. So audience is a main thing for even for any kind of stage shows, any kind of theater, any kind of concert. So we need to know what we are presenting and what is the coordination between the event production and the audience, which is very, very important. And there should be an amalgamation between both. So event staging aspect for that is really important to have a connection between the audience. And staging incorporates all aspects of the event that enable the performance to go ahead and enhances the customer's experience. So what it means? It means customer experience. Customer experience is the most important part and the integral part for any kind of event. Customer experience is must. What an audience is experience whenever he or she is at the Audi, watching your events or watching your plays, watching your theater. So that experience, we need to get that thing into them so that they experience what exactly they want to see. So that is another important integral part. It applies to the layout of the venue or event site and also what it is to be performed on stage. So yes, venue is very important for any kind of event. What kind of venue? Is it a big venue, small venue? What kind of people are coming? How many people are coming to the venue, which we'll discuss later in this presentation. But yes, venue, again, I'll say it's a very important part. Where the venue is located, how the venue is feasible, is venue good, is venue bad, is it connected or not? So we'll just discuss it later on in the presentation when we come to it. So this is an important part. So the elements that are on concern to staging include, there are many elements for the staging which are like theming and event design. So I'll just take you what theming and event design means. Theming and event design means whenever you create an event, there should be a theme to it, there should be a concept to it. So without theme, without concept, there's no use of creating an event. Because what is an event? What is the kind of shows we do? It's just an experience. If one comes to your event, comes to your site, one should experience that thing, because we create dreamlands. The person, there's a dream of everybody, but about an event, because whenever they're coming to the site, to the event, to see that, they have a different kind of prospects in their mind. And if you are able to fulfill that, then okay, we are doing a beautiful event. So the theming is very important. The theming means you are designing an event. Event design means you are designing the entire event. The designing means the entire event design means, like, you are creating the design for the event logos, you are creating the collateral for an event, you are creating the stage, you are creating entrance, you are creating exit, you are creating the entire look and feel of the event. That is important. Then, as we discussed, choosing the venue, event site, again, a very important integral part of any kind of event. What kind of venue or event is happening, where is it happening exactly, far of the city, in the city, or in your country, in different country, or like a low level land or a high level land. So this is all depend what kind of event you're doing. Then the audience and guest, another important part. Audience is very important for any kind of event. Without audience, no event. So we should have definitely an audience for any event. What kind of audience? Again, audience depend on what kind of event we are doing. Is it again a corporate, a wedding, or a concert, or a theater? Then the guest list for any event has to be good. We should have a nice guest coming to our event so that we have a good profile for our event. Then the stage is simple. What do you mean by stage? Stage is basically where the event is happening, where the entire performance, entire presentations, entire everything of the event is happening on the stage. Then comes power, lights and sound. So power, lights and sound means, like, the power is the backup on which your event is running, the electrical things on which your event is running, light and sound, the kind of lights you're having for an event, and the sound. It has to be perfect. It has to match with your event. It has to go with the creative essence of your event. Again, we come to audiovisual and special effects, which is again, that audiovisual is why it is important for any kind of event. Because if there are any corporate events, so the company want to present their company profile. If there is a singer is coming to your event, so they need the kind of technical things for their band to play on your event. So audio is very important. Then the audio visual mix, like with LED screens nowadays, coming of different special effects we are having nowadays. So special effects are really bringing an event up to the next level. So that is really important. So that next level event we are seeing nowadays, and it has become a main essence of the event management and staging. And then if we come further, so there are many other criteria for the event staging. So they are catering means, like, the kind of food you have kept in your event, what is a menu, how many people, and it all depends how many people are coming to your venue. So you have to cater your, so, and the catering means, are you catering your client for the event? Are you catering your crew for the event? Are you catering your exhibitors, your partners? So that is a different thing. But if an event, if it's a corporate event, so we have to see what kind of catering is happening in a banquet hall, how many people are need to be catered, what kind of food is there, what kind of pricing for the food is there. So we need to take care of the hygiene of the place also regarding the food. So which is really, really important. And then come the performers, the people who perform in the event, basically. And what kind of performance? It's a dance performance, it's like a stand-up comedy show, it's like a talk show, okay? Or it's like a singer are coming to perform, it's like a band which is performing. So we need to know what kind of performers are there for an event. And the performers are very, very important part. Again, I'm saying again and again, the integral part. Why? Because everything is an integral part of the event. Event means amalgamation of all these things which we are discussing in our presentation in this lesson. So we need to take care of all the things. And again, the foremost important part is the crew hospitality. Crew hospitality is again, you know, very important. Why? Because hospitality is always important for any kind of event. The hospitality cater that people coming to your event, or if you go somewhere, how you are being catered by them, or how you cater others at your event. So this is really important. Then the production schedule. So production schedule is very, very, very important for all of us, because this is the only thing which we create for an event. Our event, entire event runs on production schedule. Production schedule means the timelines. Okay, the timelines of your event, from when the event is starting, from when the production is starting, and when the event is ending, how your event has to take place, when the event has started, what are the other timelines are there on the event day. Day by day schedule has to be made. So many people don't do this kind of scheduling, and they lack, their event goes bad if they don't do a good production schedule. So good production schedules are always, always important for you. So whenever you make a production schedule, you should know exactly your timelines. You should know exactly how your event is. You should know exactly how the creative part is happening. You should know exactly what kind of performers are coming, what is your timeline, what your client wants. So you know, you create production schedule according to that, then come recording the event. So recording the event is important again. And why it is important? Because whenever event has to be recorded, because every time clients want that recording from you. Many times people do a mistake, they don't record an event, and then if the client wants, it's a bad thing for your organization that you don't have a recording for an event. But hardly it happens, but mostly now every event is getting recorded. And the main important part for recording event is that, because it becomes your own goodwill, because that becomes your event to show. If you don't do the recording, how you show the event to other people? So that is really important to show the event to the people. So again, recording the entire event as per your presentation, as per your entire performances, as per your entire speeches, as per your entire people coming to your event. So it is very, very important to have a recording of the event. Don't ever miss that. So as we move further in staging event and theme design, so here in front of you is a theme for an event which is created in a sketch mode, and it is a very initial part of theming, because this is a kind of a brief we got from a client, and it was a client brief was like Indo-French theme. We told them, okay, we'll do it in an Indo-French theme, because the client was a French, and they have a collaboration, Indian collaboration. So we have created something like Indo-French skyline, in which we can see the skyline of France, we can see the skyline of India, and in the middle of it we have a big huge LED wall in which the presentations and other performance will be seen during the event, before the event. So this is very important part to design and do the thematic part of an event again. And we'll move further. There's another design you can see here. It's an option. Whenever we go to a client, or whenever we do a theme design for any kind of stage, we should always go for an option. So that option is very, very important. Why option? Because many times clients say, okay, one, we are not able to understand. So if you have many options, so yes, your clients say, okay, dear, this is looking good. So we can go with this option. So we can finalize on this, and we can freeze on this kind of layout what you have done. So these kind of layouts are really important. Going with the initial sketches, going with the initial pencil sketch or a draft for your event. So as you can see in this layout, 1665 to 2015, so 350 years of an orphan organization, which we have shown here in like different parts of the staging. You can see in front, there's a stage, there's a backdrop to it, there's a side walls to it, and there's a LED screen to it. So this is how and what we created. An interesting part is glass wall with etching, because this theme we have designed for the company who are into making of glass. So if we are making, the company is making glass, we thought we do something related to glass. We created this wall which is being etched. So that is a glass wall which is being etched. So, okay, so we move further. So as we discuss about all the criterias before in a presentation, so we move further. So like all these elements give a physical environment to the event performance and create an impression on the audience. So all the elements which we have discussed, which we have taken for an event, So this is a physical environment. What do you mean by physical environment? This is present in front of us. So this is existing. So that makes the event performance more valuable. It gives a great impression to the audience who are watching an event. So that we need to leave an expression, an impression that is very important. As we discussed, the audience experience is very important for any kind of event. The event manager uses these elements in an innovative and artistic manner to manipulate the moods of the audience. So yes, as an event manager, we use different modes, different very creative and innovative ideas to swing the moods of an audience so that they feel themselves into an event and they become a part of it. Then all the elements concerning staging may not hold the same level of importance, different types of events. Yes, there are many kind of important thing which are there in staging. Sometimes they don't hold some kind of importance to it, but it all depends kind of events we are having, the kind of event we have planned. This means the type of event determines the relative importance of each of these elements. So many elements, like as we discuss about the catering part, if you go back to the slide, we have discussed catering. So catering goes to many things. Like catering is for the event also, but catering comes when they're having lots of many kinds of food events which we are having nowadays. So the catering plays a vital role in that. So definition of catering becomes different. So this is it. So catering is very, very important again, and the aspect of that. So things change accordingly as per the requirements. So for instance, in free events, the importance of hospitality is relatively less with respect to the importance of special effects. So what do you mean by free events? Free events is like where there is no tickets, people can come, people can be a part of it anytime. So, you know, why hospitality is not important there? Because you can't cater so many people. There are thousands of people coming to that event. It's only we have to take care of the organizing part of it, the movement of the crowd part of it, hygiene part of it, the kind of permissions part of it. So they are the important integral part of it. But taking care of the hospital, each and every guy coming to an event of this large scale event is not so easy, and which is not required actually. But you know, there are many events which are held, like they're very high-end event, like the fashion weeks happen, like the art shows happen on a large scale. So where the hospitality part is really, really important. We need to take care of the hospitality of the people coming to the, because it got a different people with different prospects. So that is really, really important. Then the important respect to the important special effects. Why we are saying this? Because special effects, when there's a very nice event happening, something like that, the special effects plays a vital role in that, because there's a people who can see, there's a vast number of people who want to see those special effects. So this is what this means. Then also the importance of particular staging element changes according to the type of the event. For example, hospitality and catering become significant during corporate events and conferences. Very true. So when corporate events happen or the conferences happen, so this hospitality and catering part is really, really important. Why? Because, you know, we have the people like the CEOs of the companies, we have the biggies coming, politicians are coming, industrialists coming in that event. And yes, there must be many celebrities who are coming for that event. So hospitality, which is the foremost part of any event, so plays a vital role here. Then the catering, what kind of food we are offering, what kind of drinks we are offering to the people coming to our event. So all these corporate events and conferences are really important for these kind of things. And when we have these corporate events and conferences, so we have a different set of people coming to and with different sector of people, we have a different kind of venue also. So that is again a very important and very interesting thing which we need to know in staging events. So when we come to theming and event design, so what it means, the foremost thing in staging an event is deciding for the theme, as I told you earlier also. So deciding the theme for an event is again an important part of it. Deciding the theme is okay, but getting it approved from the client is very, very important. If you don't get it approved from the client, if you say, okay, I'll do as per my own wish, as an event manager, so that doesn't work. So deciding on the theme, getting it approved, and work according as per the approvals is very, very important. And it is a major creative, artistic, and innovative decision to determine what the theme is. So determining the theme in an innovative and creative way is a very important part of your event. And whenever you go for these kind of themes, it has to be very, very creative, so that when somebody is coming there and watching your event, so as I spoke earlier also about the experience, that experience need to be there. So experience sharing, experiencing an event is very, very important. Then the remaining other elements such as catering, venue, audiovisual, special effects, seating, arrangement, decoration, performers are designed or created to fit in with the theme. So everything has to be fit in the theme. And many times it happens, we do many, many events like a thematic event. So if you are doing something like an Indo-French theme, Indo-Thai theme, so yes, if we have a fusion of an Indo French food, the Indo-Thai food, it really works. It really, your audience or your guest feels really good about it. So thematic things is in everything, even your audiovisual, even your special effects, even your entire setup. So that is really, really important. So we need to take care of that also. Then you can see a small layout here, staging elements revolving around the theme. So this means we have a theme in the center. Whatever the theme is, our venue is according to that, audio, visual, and special effects are according to that, then the catering, then the artist entertainment and speakers, props and decoration, and sound and light. So theme, according to theme, everything revolves, which is very interesting actually. Whatever theme we decide, so many times what we do, if we decide on a theme, the thing come, okay, we'll take this kind of venue. So that venue will really suit our theme, then everything comes into under one umbrella. Then we start designing the props, we start designing the decor according to our theme. We call artists, what kind of artists will come to entertain people, then what kind of sound and light, and what kind of catering, what kind of food. So that is also according to the theme. If you are having a theme called, like, supposedly we do a theme on a Mela theme or a very Indianized theme or a Rajasthani theme, so yes, we'll be in catering what we required, a proper Indian food or a Rajasthani themed food. So that is really important. And if, as I told you earlier, also Indo-French and Indo-Thai, so same thing happens. So everything revolves around our theme. So the event can be of any type or nature, but once the theme for the event is established, rest of the activities, event production, take shape accordingly. So what it means? It means that there are many kind of events, like the fashion shows are here, the art shows are there, or a show like Comic-Con we do. It's very, that caters to the young breed. So many young people from the college, from the school, and even the biggies come to that event and they just enjoy. So it got a very different kind of thematic aspect. So that theme, whenever we design the theme, the entire event takes shape accordingly. What kind of branding we are having, what kind of entry we are having, what kind of entire setup we are having, whom we are calling to an event. So it comes under one roof. So that is how it takes shape. And then, for instance, an event theming medieval India will have decoration, food, catering, hospitality, entertainers, sound and special effects of the medieval period, complementing the theme of the event, as I told you earlier also. The same, like the medieval India theme will have the same, the decoration related to that, food, catering, hospitality related to that, and obviously the entertainers, sound and special effects, all should complement each other as per the theme, which is really, really important. So we need to take care of that, all those things, so that our event goes flawless and event becomes a very creative part. Then in many activation experiential marketing events, nowadays a thematic zone with a demo zone is created, which is a simple example, like experiential marketing are happening so that the customer comes there and he can or she can experience the product. Supposedly an iPhone or a watch gadget is there. So one can go and feel and see, take that iPhone in the hand and they can see or some any kind of gadget is getting promoted. So this is becoming a very important aspect. That's experiential marketing. Nowadays is becoming a very important part of any kind of event. And that also has to be thematic. People are creating demo zones for that. And many people come, look and have a feel of that event, how that will look in their hand or how it goes with their attitude, with their own personalities. So, and the customer can really try those product there. So, thus, it will not be wrong to say that all the elements work in close relationship with each other and around the themes. All the elements, as we say, revolve around the theme, as we have seen that diagram in which we have seen the theme and everything are revolving around that. So, that is again very important. So, here you can see some layouts we have done for an event. This is just a 3D layout with LED screen, with stage setup, with seating. So, this is an option. So, this we have tried the option. Then you can see another layout. This is a second option. As I told you, when you go for a presentation, we should have options. So, those options are really, really important for us always. So, we need to take care, we need to draw those options, we need to have a creative mindset for creating all these things. So, very, very important again. Then we move further. So, you can see the exact setup as per our theme created. This is an exact picture of the show happened here for Avon. You can see, and these are some effects you can see in the slide. And as we move further, these are some more special effects as per the lighting, as per the audio visual techniques. And we can see the kind of rays coming from top of the truss and falling on the stage. So, this is a very good example of thematic design. And again, we come to choosing the venue, event site. So, event purpose and finalization of theme opens out options for the selection of venue. In fact, sometimes the venue becomes an obvious part of the theme of the event. As I asked, as we spoke earlier about the venue, venue is again an important part. Why venue? So, venue or any kind of event site is important. If the venue is far off, then people won't come, much people won't come to your event. So, if the venue is well located, it's in the center of the city, it's been very much hygienically done, it's been sanitized, it's been taken care of by the local authorities like police, traffic, or the top level people. And the most important part of the venue is it has to be connected with your public transport. The metro is coming there, it is connected with other, it has been connected with the local taxis and all. And again, the roads to your venue has to be clean, has to be well lighted, has to be proper. There is no hooliganism at that place. So we need to take care of all those things, which is really, really important. So setting up a venue, one of the foremost thing or any event, if the venue is not there, so no event can happen. No? So venue is very, very important. When you choose a venue, you go, then you go for a theme. Many times it happens, you decide a theme, then according to your theme, you choose a venue. So your venue could be outdoor, indoor, you create your own venue through different parts. Okay, so this is how the events are being done nowadays. And selection of venue is actually a critical component in event staging, as it will affect the layout and performance of other elements of event staging. So selection of venue, as I told you, is a critical component, is a very integral part, so that people come to your venue. You should have a nice coverage for your venue. You should have nice people coming to your venue. So again, an important part of that. So we should know the venue, how the event has to be taken. So I hope this must have got you in some understanding about the stage design, stage themes, and how the you can create the thematic design to your event, and why this stage theme, stage design is very important to you and for any kind of event. So hope this lesson gives you a great insight. Thank you.